generosity and enjoyment rather than self-denial. And amid all the trendy cafes pushing the latest trends in dieting, one bakery has taken it back to basics. We have Cherie Bevan and Tass Tauroa. They're also known as the Cook and the Baker, and they join us now. Hi.
Thank you.
First up, who's the cook, who's the baker? Oh, well, we should know by... You're the baker?
I'm the cook.
Oh, cook, baker, yes, there we go.
So
right.
So why did you decide to team up together?
Well, we've worked together off and on for over 20 years, hasn't it been?
22 years.
And so it was just inevitable that eventually we would do something. We've had a big passion for baking. So we thought we'll open a bakery.
Well, you've brought in some amazing treats today. What have you got here? You're going to finish off this breakfast bar, is that right? Yes.
Well, that's our breakfast bar. That's great, a morning snack.
And, so what's in it?
So we've got oats, walnuts, brown sugar, butter, cinnamon, honey from our rooftop.
Okay, so you've just taken it out of the oven?
It's just come out of the oven. We're going to finish it with our dried fruit compote.
Apricots, cranberries, apples.
So is this paleo approved, gluten free,
sugar free? That's what our bakery is all about.
What do you think about all of these kind of food trends?
Look, we think everything in moderation.
Yeah.
You know, I think we opened up in Bondi Junction amongst a lot of health food stores and organic stores, and so we were sort of like the evil store that opened.
So we bucked the trend.
What are you putting on now?
This is part of the base, and then we've also got a lot of seeds in there. Buckwheat, hulled millet,
linseeds,
and sunflower seeds.
This is for breakfast, is it?
Certainly is.
Oh, breakfast is going to be good. Bad luck, you guys.
So it's really good food, good, tasty food.
Yeah,
and
absolutely.
It's about not denying yourself. What a fantastic philosophy.
Yeah.
Well, absolutely. We think so. I mean, we're Kiwis, you know, so I think we grew up with lots of butter and cream and hence what.
And that's that. So what do you do?
And then that gets baked in the oven for another 15 to 20 minutes.
And that'll all settle?
That'll all settle, crunchy.
Then you carve it up.
Keep it in the fridge, and it's a great breakfast on the go.
And for lunch, we have a fish pie?
Yes.
A beautiful fish pie. Now, what's
well,
fish?
That one's
salmon?
Well, normally we use blue eye cod, but we couldn't get any this morning, so we've just used smoked trout, which is pretty amazing. Mm. And there's lots of fennel, celeriac, onion, celery, just bound together with beautiful bechamel sauce, which is amazing. And then we just finish that off with some beautiful mash.
Oh.
And, lots of cream and butter and all the good stuff.
If I could eat mashed potato all day, every day, that's what
exactly
I would eat.
This is a really good dish to pre-make, have it in the fridge. You can then just pull it out into the oven and...
So you make all this in a pot, then you put it into this dish that's going to go into the oven.
Yes, yeah. And then just serve it with a fabulous salad.
I know, it just smells absolutely amazing. I love this philosophy. Now, we've got... finally, what's this?
That is our rustic freeform tart. So it's a pizza dough, and it's filled with a ricotta, caramelised onion, pumpkin filling.
Oh, my gosh.
Again, this is the pizza dough. The filling can be made in advance in the fridge the day before and then just pop together.
Brilliant.
And very quickly, that?
This is our flourless mandarin marmalade cake. It's a gluten-free, dairy-free cake. So one of our biggest sellers. You know, in the store.
In the hipster areas.
Yeah.
You've got a cookbook which puts together all of these recipes as well, which is fantastic. You say you're both Kiwis.
Yes.
Why have you got an Australian recipe in there?
the pavlova.
We knew we were going to get that question.
New Zealand has put kiwi fruit on
and we
put strawberries.
You guys are just lovely, and your food is tremendous. Thanks so much for coming in.
Thank you.
The cook and the baker.